As I traced the pinhole image of a partial eclipse of the sun one day by old Uluru Rock, I knew it had begun. And soon it dawned upon my mind, as I sketched that afternoon, that when its fullness waxed around, eclipsed would be the moon. So I went to old Mount Isa, where the smokestack meets the sky, and lodged at the youth hostel and waited, by and by, when the full moon lit the heavens on a certain sultry night. I knew the time was drawing near, and I went to see the sight. I walked past furnace, one by one, of Isa's belching smoke, of copper and molybdenum, of silver in the choke. I walked nigh 10 miles out of town, far from synthetic light, and lay down in the outback dust to watch the sky that night. For it was 1986, and raging in the sky, the hoary beard of Halley's was just then passing by. And as the moon's light dimmed away by the shadow of the earth, that comet lit my anxious eye as I lay there in the dirt. And then, returning through the town, walking beside a wall, I came upon a gap in it. Not that big at all. Presently out came 3 large bulls, and prancing in a trot, I heard the music of their hooves, and I in quite a spot. For these magnificent creatures were of the feral type. I privileged, then, did walk with them in the moonlit sultry night. Or how to tell the feeling, or to describe the thoughts, or to relay in poetry what I was there then taught. We are a part of the universe, and part then of the whole. Let's roll our swag and loose the slag, for the world's beyond control. We try to use our money to measure what we've done, forgetting then what is for free, and think to buy our fun.